All right, so this tutorial is going to be doing a swatch-based system, something that looks a little bit like this, where you can pull in the image from your various different products and create some navigation in between it. So now, if you're trying to do this, you might also want to be creating some type of linked product system where, say, for instance, a t-shirt has a pair of pants that matches and a specific pairs of shoes. Now, this is one of two ways of doing it, so stick around and let's get started. Right, so what we're going to be doing is basically creating this a little module here, and as I said before, you can basically use the same technique to create linked products for like shirts, t-shirts, pants, or whatever else you would want to display on this particular product page. One thing to mention, that this is not using the object variant or the product variant system, so it's not having a color as a option and then size, pack size, or whatever it is. It is creating individual products for each page. And then what we're doing is we're using a multi-reference object in order to basically say, I want to display these particular products on this particular page. So it's kind of a sneaky little hack around, but it gives you a little bit more flexibility in order to kind of design, do like rollover states and whatnot natively without having to kind of do it from a code level, which can be a little bit complicated, but I will do that eventually. So what this is going to need is it's going to need a Metafields plugin, something that has a multi-reference field, because Shopify, although it can do this, it only references one product at a time. So you need something that basically you can say, yep, I want that one, that one, that one, that one, and that one to come onto this particular page. The plugin I recommend the most, because I just really like it, is Accentuate Custom Fields, and it comes with all the code and stuff like that we need to try and to recreate. So don't worry, I'm going to take you through that, so you don't really have to read this unless you really want to. Some limitations with this particular way of working. One, you can only have 20 swatches, because basically we're using a thing called all products in order to basically search the Shopify data and then basically present it. And Shopify has a limit of 20 products for that. Also, what this assumes is that every single one of your product colors is a separate product, basically. So you can still have small, medium, and large as a variant, but each of your products are, so if it's a black, red, purple, green, whatever, they're all separate product pages. So yeah, just to confirm the product setup, so you've got here all of the different products, and if I click into one of these, you can see that the variant size is down here, but it has nothing to do with the color. The color is just this for Joa. Important to note. Okay, so what we need to do is firstly we need to set up the multi-reference field and also a color label, because if you want to use the title, sometimes titles get really long, and if you've got color in there, it's going to be a bit long. And if we look at our example here, we can, as I roll over, you can see it says dolphin, Joa, milk, etc. So we're just basically passing another meter field to that value that has the color value. But first things first, what we're going to do is just head on over to our Shopify store. As you can see, I've already set up some products, so if you haven't got those already, then do so. Then we're going to go into our apps. Again, I use Accentuate Custom Fields, link below if you want it. Okay, we go into there and we go into products and we're going to create a new field and we're going to call it color swatch products. I've already written this before because I've done this tutorial before already. And we're going to have this as products as well. This is in the namespace. Okay, so hit on next. All right, now we're just going to scroll down and find the reference products, and that's that. So allow multiple items, we definitely want that, and that's that. Okay, now we just need to do the next one, which is basically just a text object, and we can do that again just following those, and we'll call it color label. And products again, keep it all grouped in terms of the namespaces. Next, and it's just a text file. One line would be fine, and done. Sorted. Now all we want to do is just open this particular field up and just copy this meter field here. Okay? Right, so here we are in Webflow, and basically what we need to do now is just create the structure in order to get this to work. So now the thing with reference fields is what we need to do is we have to assign it to like a variable, and then that particular multi-reference field, we need to be able to say, okay, fine, we have to split this in a specific way. Now, if we go to the documentation, quite handily, they've already kind of given us the structure that we want to do, and we want to recreate this in Webflow. So in order to do this portion, it's pretty simple. We just literally copy that and we would head on over into Webflow. And then you can see here, I've created an embed code before the swatch functionality. And then I've just probably popped it in here. So all it needing to do is saying assign, we're calling it the variable swatches. And we're saying that variable needs to be getting this particular information. But because it's a multi-reference object, we need to split it. And it's being split by that bar. Sort of. That code is going to be below. So follow along. Just to keep clear, you can call this anything you want, as long as if it is unique to that particular piece of code. So it could be Frank or whatever, but swatches are swatches, etc., and makes it easy. So just save and close that, and that particular thing is done. Okay, so now we're going to need to create the swatches system. So there's a few things we need to do. Firstly, what you're going to do is just create a link block. And what we will need to do is we first need to add a for loop down here, and we say liquid for, and we go for swatch in swatches. So swatches, which is in our code here. So what we've assigned swatches, and we're saying for basically every single swatch within swatches, loop through that. Okay, so liquid for, and then swatches and swatches, or color variant and color variance, whatever you want to call it really, as long as that if it lines up with what your variable is. So there's your variable, and this is the individual piece within that particular variable. Okay, and then what we want to do is we want to add an HTML attribute, and what we're looking for, so it's HTML attribute. If you're not sure where you find that, if you go into the university and you scroll down, you have HTML attributes down here, and this just basically allows you to apply HTML attributes to an object. Okay, so you can literally just copy that, head on back into here. We want to paste that, and then what we're looking for is we're changing the link, which is the href. So we go into Visual Studio Code. So this is the link that we need to create. So href bar, open the curly brackets for our liquid, and we're saying all products, we're getting the swatch, and we want the .url. That's the object information we want. So pretty straightforward. Again, linked below in the description. So we just copy that, go into here, and I'll just replace that there. All right, so now what it's saying is for all of the swatches in this watch, I want to get this particular swatch's URL. All right, makes sense. Fine, don't worry about the bind, that's because I run it further forward. It will do that automatically once you spit this out. All right, so next things next, we want to basically get the image. Now you can see I'm not using an image object or element that you would just drag and drop. I'm using a code embed. And the reason being is I don't want to be serving the full-sized image within Shopify. So basically on the swatch, I don't want to be loading the 2000 pixel wide image for the swatch. I only need like 160 pixels or less. So I want to use the compact one. And the easiest way to do this without kind of having to go and manually code it later on is just to basically drop in a code block and pop in this little piece of code, which is down below, and Bob's your uncle, you're done. So all it is doing is saying, it's giving an image tag and the source. We're specifying again, open brackets. We're looking again for those all products. We're going through the swatch in swatches, see, and featured image. And then what we're doing here is we're saying, give me an image URL, but I want it to be the compact size. Okay, so it's pretty straightforward. And then the other bit there is basically just doing the alt text. So same thing, all products swatch dot featured image dot alt. So it's just that combination that basically says, I want that piece of image, that piece of information from your object. Okay, so we'll just copy that. I'm just doing this again for your benefit. Go into your newly created embed and just place that, save and close. That portion's done. So now that image will get pulled in and it will reference through and I'll go, hey, yeah, I want you. Cool. All right, so now your swatch overlay is pretty straightforward. All I've done here is I put a very simple interaction. So I'll just show you. So it's a swatch hover. So it's got an opacity, it's got a move and a filter, and then it just does that type of thing in terms of the swatch heading and the overlay. So within here, we've just got two things. We've got the overlay and we've got the swatch heading. So the swatch heading, again, we want to get some information because we want to basically pull in that meter field, that one that we created additionally, just the text field. So all we need to do is use a liquid object custom attribute provided by Udesly. So head into here, just copy that liquid object, go back into this and plop that in there. Now you think we just head on over to Shopify, grab the meter field, plop it in there, and we're job done. You're partly right, because we still have to convert it to that for all products swatch and then the meter field. So we have to do a slight conversion. So if we go into here, we would just go and grab our color label. So drop down there, grab it, you see a product meter field, blah, blah, blah. And what you would normally do is just basically drop it in there, but it's not going to work. So get that out, head on to your code editor. And what we're doing is we're going all products swatch. We are adding a dot. We're removing, if we're looking at the custom code that we've got product, meter fields, products, color, blah, blah. We don't need this products here. So all we're needing to do is basically get all products within swatch, meter field, and then we want to get the products, which is the namespace, and this is the label value of that particular thing. So we don't need those curly brackets. We just need to grab that bit here and then head on back into here, and we can just pop that there and hit save. So that is it. Not complicated. All right, so what we need to do now is just publish that. Again, all the code, everything is in below. If you've got questions, there's the community tab I've now opened up, and go from there. Okay, so final step is we've just got to set up those labels and the created fields within Shopify. So I'm going to quickly kind of time step through this, but it's pretty straightforward. I'm just going to each product and just editing the custom fields.
A few moments later.
Okay, so that's done. Don't forget to hit save, because if you don't hit save, it doesn't save. It's the same when you create the meter fields. If you're not seeing the meter fields there, it's because you haven't hit save when you created them. I will put a note there, because guess what? Time machine. I didn't hit save. Okay, so that's all done. Roll into here, and then what we can do is we can just preview the product, and there's our swatch system. So we can see it's got all of the things that are coming up, milk, blah, blah, blah. And if I hit on Fijoa, it'll change the page. The cool thing about doing it this way is that here I can see there's only one variant available, and the variant logic basically works. If I have multiple options, then you will get if the product's out of stock, it will say it on the bottom, say it's this product's out of stock. If you only have one variant option, i.e. size, it will then say, okay, fine, if that particular variant's out, then apply the out of stock state, which you can create in Webflow, and you say kind of disabled there, which you can change the CSS. So this particular example, it's applying the not available state to there. If I had another option here, it wouldn't give me that. It would basically just say, when I clicked on it, it would be a little banner that would come underneath saying this product is not available in this particular quantity. But because we've taken color out of the option set, so it's its own product page, we only have size to contend with here. So it's not an issue. So we get this particular UI, which a lot of people have been asking about. This is a way of working around that. So hopefully that helps a lot of you. All right, that's it. So if you haven't subscribed, please do so. It really helps me out. And I'll see you in the next tutorial. Cheers. Bye.